In the span of less than a year, the world went from looking like this to looking like this. With the arrival of COVID-19, people in countries around the world faced the new expectation of wearing a mask. Yet in Japan and other East Asian Pacific countries, wearing masks is not a new phenomenon. In fact, it is a well-established cultural custom. Even before the pandemic took over, people in Japan wore masks for a variety of reasons. Masks are expected when someone is sick with a cold or flu. They're even worn for non-medical purposes. Some Japanese women admit that they often wear masks if they don't feel like putting on makeup that day. So when COVID-19 flooded across the world earlier this year, it was nothing new for Japanese people to put on a face mask before heading to work. In the United States, there has been a far different response to the use of medical face masks. Many people are resisting the practice, stating that being forced to wear a mask violates their personal freedoms. Why is the practice of wearing a mask so differently received in the US compared to Japan? Simply put, because cultural differences impact the way mask wearing is accepted in each respective country. Japan is a collectivist country. This means that they have a view of self that stresses connectedness, communities, relationships, and social environments. Collectivists see themselves as integral or embedded parts of the communities they live in. Within Japanese culture, there is a strong sense of shared identity. They place great importance on belonging in their community or group. Norms, a type of expected behavior, and rules are important in maintaining their national solidarity. Japanese citizens also embody a widely shared attitude of accepting and trusting government involvement and action. This allows people to create a tightly knit community guided by rules and norms. Because of this, people in Japan wear masks not to protect themselves, but to protect others around them. Wearing a mask is seen not as a way to protect the individual, but a way to protect the community and nation as a whole. Wearing a mask is seen as a symbol of respect. Not wearing a mask, especially during this pandemic, is seen as rude and disrespectful to the people around them, to the larger community, and even to the nation as a whole. If someone were to not wear a mask, they would be going directly against what is expected behavior. They would risk being singled out and excluded from their group. They could be openly criticized or socially rejected. But how exactly did mask wearing in Japan become this valued cultural norm? Well, they have had past experiences with epidemics. In 1918 through 1919, the world witnessed an influenza epidemic that took the lives of millions. During this time, countries around the world, including the US and Japan, wore masks to combat the disease. While other countries stopped the practice after the epidemic subsided, many Japanese people continued to wear masks in their everyday lives. Then in 2009 came the swine flu threat, and in 2011 the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear disaster. In all of these cases, Japan heavily advertised and promoted mask wearing. They represented fighting disease as a national objective, connecting directly to the importance placed on national solidarity. Business owners and the government collaborated to enforce mask wearing. Because of the Japanese attitude towards accepting government action, mask wearing became a widespread behavior. From here, it became normalized behavior with the help of Japan's cultural environment, specifically the Japanese beliefs around cleanliness. One aspect of Japanese culture revolves around the distinction between purity, things that are clean, and impurity, things that are dirty. There is this idea that things considered inside are pure while things outside are impure. This cultural idea is seen clearly through another normalized behavior in Japan, the Japanese ritual of genkan, or the removal of shoes when entering a household. People are expected to take off their shoes before entering a house in order to separate the outside from the inside, or the impure from the pure. Mask wearing may play a similar role in Japan. By wearing face masks, people are separating what is outside from what is inside. They are limiting contact with the outside, unclean substances. This frame of mind might help explain why mask wearing was so normalized in Japan prior to the current pandemic. When COVID-19 came around, it was nothing new for Japan to start wearing masks in their everyday lives. On the other hand, wearing face masks was not normalized to such an extent in the United States. Why? Well, while Japan is a collectivist culture, the United States is an individualistic country. This means that in the US, there is a culture that has an individualized view of self. Emphasis is put on personal success and personal control. Individual rights are expected to be protected under the law. Even American patriotism, a core cultural value in the United States, is deeply rooted in this idea of individual liberties. While Japan's cultural focus on collectivism reinforces strong ideas of cleanliness that supports mask wearing, the US cultural value of individual rights often leads to distrust in the government. There is a strong belief in individual freedoms. Many people in the US reject government involvement and intervention in a variety of matters. This has made enforcing mask wearing a particularly difficult task. Unlike Japan, mask wearing was not a part of the US culture prior to the COVID-19 outbreak. Before the pandemic, seeing a healthy person wearing a mask was extremely uncommon. In fact, covering one's face with a mask is commonly framed in a negative light. Picture a bank robber wearing a mask. They do so to conceal their identity, for nefarious purposes. Now, in the midst of COVID-19, two groups of people have arisen in the US, those who wear masks and those who don't, and both sides openly criticize each other. Not only that, but the debate has become a political issue. When the pandemic spread throughout the world, the US was in the middle of an important election year. This made the debate around mask wearing and other preventative measures very politicized in nature. While some people accepted government involvement related to enforcing mask wearing, many others rejected it, arguing that it is a violation of their personal freedoms. Now take a second and notice the word personal here. It emphasizes the individual rather than the group. People in the US choose whether or not to wear a mask largely based on the evidence of it protecting themselves from harm. I shouldn't have to wear a mask because it doesn't guarantee my protection. There is also a commonality in the idea that wearing a mask is an individual's choice, that if they are to get sick, it would only impact them and not the community around them. So you have on one hand, those in Japan who wear masks to protect other people, and on the other hand, in the US, you have some people who choose not to wear masks because they don't see the personal benefit in doing so. Groups of people choose not to wear masks because they distrust the evidence showing that masks prevent the spread of disease. These people do not think that the government should have the power to force them to participate in a behavior that impedes their daily lives, especially if they believe there is insufficient proof of the protection that masks will provide them. The idea that mandatory mask wearing violates personal freedoms, coupled with the widespread belief that masks are meant to protect the individual wearer from harm, have created a complex environment in the US. Taking a step back, what does this all mean? Well, it seems clear that the success of widespread mask wearing largely depends on the culture that is trying to adopt the practice. If the United States wishes to see the implementation of mask wearing during this COVID-19 pandemic, it might be helpful if the country as a whole works to embrace a cultural shift away from individualistic thought and more towards a collectivist attitude. Moving the conversation away from masks as a way to protect the individual wearer might also be beneficial. Instead, talking about masks as a way to protect the larger community around them. Some have suggested that if the practice were to be framed as a patriotic act, one that protects the nation as a whole, perhaps people might be more receptive to participating in the behavior. Additionally, getting people to wear masks may not have to be backed up by strict government intervention. Instead, it could be framed as a community expectation, like the common phrase, "no shoes, no service."